Alright, on today's episode, we're going to be checking out Metallica, The Four Horsemen, with Dave Lombardo. I don't really know, much about the backstory of how this came about, but I did see them talking about how Lars had to
take a dump.
Yeah, he had to take a big dump. No, but they said that he got like injured or something, had to go to the doctor or hospital, but they didn't really say what. But it sounded like people filled in the whole night, like different drummers, which I would like to see the rest of the show, but yeah. These were a few songs that they did with Dave Lombardo, so we're going to check out The Four Horsemen.
Metallica is here once again. And I'm telling you, we feel better than ever. Are you feeling good tonight? Metallica is here to make you feel better, all right?
Yeah,
well,
now,
brother.
Now, we've got the album Kill 'Em All out there.
Snap into a sweet chip, brother.
Because there are four people on stage right here.
So we got Slayer, Suicidal Tendencies.
Came in hot right there, man.
That was good.
That was kind of funny.
That was hilarious.
That was like when you hit puberty, right? I kind of want to go back, but
there you go, boy. That's cool. I like how
I'm not really missing Lars.
No, man.
Sounds really good.
Sounds rad. I like it.
Yeah. The thing with Lars is, I think Lars is a really good songwriter. I think he's good at composing and whatnot. I think he's good at drumming like Lars, but Dave Lombardo's next level. I mean,
Dave Lombardo's some shit.
He's pretty badass. He's
making it sound good. I like how they did. They don't take many chances on wardrobe. All black.
You Metallica?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, man. They've been just, they like that
it's
all black.
It's all black all the time.
Yeah, yeah.
I guess that's the thing.
No risk, man. It's easy, too.
Yeah. Slimming.
Slimming. I think James has been so happy ever to play his songs, man. He's loving playing with Lombardo. I think Lars, you know, that was pretty cool of him to let people fill in, man, but Jesus. Lombardo rips, dude. I wanna hear Metallica with Dave Lombardo all the time.
That'd be cool, man.
Every time you see Lars now, he seems like he's always tired, like every time he finishes a song. He's just like,
hold on, one moment. We're doing one. We'll be right back.
This is that Megadeth song, right? Too, The Mechanics. Have you heard that?
Yeah.
Dave Mustaine helped write this song.
Yeah, you're. Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe even wrote the whole entire thing. I don't know.
Yeah.
I've listened to the Mechanics, and the lyrics are pretty much the only thing that really sets. I think it's different. Yeah, but it's actually about a mechanic. Yeah, it's like metaphors for, I think, for having sex, but like. As a mechanic, like, you know, like driving the pistons in the air or something, you know.
I'll have to check that out. I gotta change it. It's a throw the beat. Call it.
Yeah, it sounds so good. I must say, other than Hetfield's little, like, prepubescent
little
screeches, he sounds really good.
He's always a good singer.
Yeah,
man.
He is always a good singer, but
and
he,
like,
sounds great right here.
To me, he's, like, one of the hardest rock singers to sing, too. He's got such a mid-range, it's on point, clean voice, but he can also...
He's got a little bit of... Yeah. And he definitely emphasizes that a lot, you know.
But he's always got that... You know, that singing
it
kind of quality.
It cuts through.
No!
Yeah, he's a good singer. Saying earlier, it's kind of crazy that, I mean, in this performance you have Rob Trujillo, Suicidal Tendencies, and then you got the Slayer drummer. It's kind of surreal.
It's pretty incestuous little community.
It'd be cool to see maybe a concert where, like, all the people, like, switch
all stars, man.
Yeah, yeah. I remember I had this album.
I don't know why they don't do that. Why? I mean,
well,
too hard to coordinate with bands.
I had an album once where it was like it was Rancid and NOFX, and they each did six songs, but they did each other's songs.
Yeah, yeah.
So they, like, flipped it. Mm-hmm. So, like, the Rancid did six NOFX songs, and they did it their way, and it was really interesting. But that could be like a concert concept too, you know?
They could do that. It's the All Stars of Rock, man.
Yeah, All Stars of Rock. There you go.
You're badass.
Hammer does play some pretty tasty leads. He's got a nice ear, you know.
I think he gets bored of shredding so hard.
Cool. I wonder if Dave Lombardo would have been able to save that When Doves Cry cover.
I don't think so, man. That was pretty terrible. That was the worst thing I think I've ever seen.
Even Dave Lombardo can't do that.
No, man, that was terrible.
Yeah, that was cool. I'd like to see a whole concert with Dave Lombardo playing with all kinds of bands, but Metallica, that sounded rad. It had,
dude,
I feel like it had a lot of energy, like the old 80s Metallica.
We'll see, right? Mike Patton singing, Les Claypool on bass, Dave Lombardo on drums.
There you go.
Who on guitar? Who on guitar? Slash or something?
The Hetfield, I don't know.
Yeah. Possibilities are endless.
There you go. Well, I did like that, and I'd recommend it.
1, 2, 3, 4, Horseman. Right. That was it.
Dave Mustaine, man, he must be so pissed about that.
He is pissed.
He is pissed. He wants that royalty.
He's pissed. He's red. He's got red hair. That's why he's pissed.
All right. If you like this episode, give us a like. Give us a subscribe.
Check our channel.
Hit the notification bell, and we'll see you again next time.